You observe this third question. ABCB3 sets such that A union B equal to A union C and A intersection B equal to A intersection C. Then show that B equal to C. ABCB3 sets such that A union B equal to A union C, A intersection B equal to A intersection C. Then show that B equal to C. Here, we need to prove that B equal to C by using these two conditions. Okay. Here, B equal to C means two sets are equal. When we say two sets are equal, suppose the set B is a subset of C and the set C is subset of B. In this case, both the cases holds good. Then only we say that the sets B and C are equal. I hope you understand. So here, to prove the sets, these two sets are equal, B equal to C, first I need to prove that B is subset of C. Next, I need to prove that C is subset of B. Okay, so let's start the solution. Before starting the solution, first you write the given data. What they given? They given that A union B equal to A union C. And they given, you try to understand, that means both must holds good, then only this works. A intersection B equal to A intersection C. We need to prove that B equal to C. Okay. I said now, to prove this, I'll do this in two cases. First, I'll prove that B is subset of C. When B is subset of C and C is also subset of B, then I can say that these two sets are equal. How to prove that B is subset of C? Very simple. I'll take one random element X in set B. By using these two datas, I'll prove that X is there in set C also. So if all the elements present in set B are present in set C, then I can say that B is subset of C. So what is the procedure to prove that B is a subset of C? I'll take X belongs to B. Okay, so we started like this. Let X belongs to set B. Okay, if X belongs to set B, can you say that X belongs to A union B? If X belongs to B, then definitely X belongs to A union B. This we learn in operations on sets. While learning the definition of union of sets, we learn this. If X belongs to B, then definitely X belongs to A union B. Okay. X belongs to A union B. If X belongs to B, then X belongs to A union B. Okay. And we know that they given here, A union B is same as A union C. So what I can write here, X belongs to A union C, I can write, since they given that A union B is same as A union C. Okay. X belongs to A union C. X belongs to A union C means what? X is in set A or X is in set C? Here, two chances are there. X is there in set A or X is there in set C or X may present in both also. Basic thing is X belongs to A or X belongs to C. When X belongs to A intersection C, X may be in set A, X may be in set C. Listen carefully. If X is in set C, this problem is over. I am trying to prove B is subset of C. If X belongs to B, when I got that X belongs to C, I can say that B is subset of C. If X belongs to C, directly I can say that B is subset of C. Because for X belongs to B, X belongs to C. For X belongs to B implies X belongs to C, then I can say that B is subset of C. Okay. So here, only the problem comes when X belongs to A. Okay. Suppose when X is in A, when X belongs to set A, what happens? Here, as I started with X belongs to B, if X is there in set A, then what I can say? I can say that X belongs to A intersection B. Since we started with X belongs to B. Now I am saying that when X belongs to A, X belongs to B. That means when x is there in set A as well as there in set B, then definitely I can say that x belongs to A intersection B. Okay, x belongs to A intersection B. X belongs to A intersection B. You can look here in the given data, they given that A intersection B is same as A intersection C. X belongs to A intersection B is same as A intersection C. So in place of A intersection B, I can write A intersection C. When X belongs to A intersection C, then what I can say? I can say that X belongs to A and intersection means X will be there in A as well as in C also. X belongs to C. Because it is intersection, A intersection C means X is there in A intersection C. It means that X must present in A, X must present in C also. I hope you are understanding. So I started with X belongs to B, I ended with X belongs to C. So what is the conclusion I will give here? Therefore, X belongs to B implies X belongs to C. From this, what I can conclude? I can conclude that B is subset of C. I hope you understand this. I proved that. Similarly, if I can prove that C is subset of B, then this problem will be over. Actual thing is what? I am trying to prove that the set B equal to C. How to prove? First, I'll prove that B is subset of C. Next, I'll prove that C is subset of B. Now, this one is over. Now, I need to prove that C is subset of B. Okay. I need to prove that the set C is a subset of B. How to prove this? Very simple. First, I'll take one element in set C. X belongs to C, I'll take. In the process, I'll simplify and I'll get that X belongs to B. If I can prove this, then I can say that C is subset of B. Okay. Start with the X belongs to B. Let X belongs to C. Start with X belongs to C. I take an X in set C. If X belongs to C, then definitely X belongs to A union C. Clear? If X belongs to C, then definitely X belongs to A union C. This is clear from operations on sets. If you know how to calculate union of sets, then you can easily understand, right? Okay, X belongs to A union C. And A union C is same as A union B. That is the given data. X belongs to, look here. A union C is same as A union B. In place of A union C, I can write A union B. Okay. In place of A union C, I can write A union B. Since A union C is same as A union B. Okay. Right. So now X belongs to A union B means what? X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Correct? A union B means X may be in set A or X may be in set B. Here you observe, if X is in set B, this problem is over because I started with X belongs to C and X belongs to B, then I can easily say that C is subset of B. Only the problem arises when X belongs to A. Okay, look here. When X belongs to A, as I started with X belongs to C, I can easily write that X belongs to A intersection C. X belongs to A as well as X belongs to C. X belongs to A intersection C. So what I can say here, X belongs to A intersection C. And you see, A intersection C is same as what they given in the data. A intersection C is same as A intersection B. Look here. A intersection C is same as A intersection B. In place of A intersection C, what I can write? I can write A intersection B because they given A intersection C is same as A intersection B. Okay. When X is there in A intersection B, X is there in A as well as X is there in B also. From this, I can easily say that X belongs to B. Now you observe, I started with X belongs to C, I got that X belongs to B. So I'll write here, therefore, if X belongs to C implies X belongs to B, then what is the conclusion? Then the conclusion is C is subset of B. Here we proved that B is subset of C, you take it as 1. And here we proved that C is subset of B, you take it as 2. From 1 and 2, what we can say? When B is subset of B and C is subset of B, then I can say that the sets B and C are equal. So here this condition holds good only when this full, look here, this result holds good when A union B equal to A union C as well as A intersection B equal to A intersection C. When both are holds good, then only B equal to C. I hope you understand this third question.